Hi, my lovelies. Another deck arrived. Another swap result deck. And this is the Tarot of Fire, which was in my A-list and it arrived yesterday. I had a quick look and I really love it. I knew I would, but let's look at them together. This is the box it arrives in. The flame of knowledge never dies. Los Carabillo, little white book, which actually I will peek in a little bit because some things I noticed maybe would be interesting to add to the cards from there. And we will go the Fool. The Fool is said to be an elf of Truck. Maybe it's pronounced like that. I'm gonna show you how it's right here. And this is Germanic mythology. A sort of goblin that dwells in homes, a ball of fire that enters through the chimney, tottering on the roof of the house or the world. His deeds are always balanced on the fine line between instinct and reason. In my country, we have similar elf or deity for the fire, in other words, like fire god, and he is called Lauritz. Here we have a special day for him in the summer, and there are many stories about him in our folklore. Some of them say that when someone has mistreated the fire and burned down their house or destroyed the nature, then the water drops in the morning, which is, I don't know the word in English, the early morning water drops on the grass, you know? These are his tears, because he's been crying and sad because people can't treat the fire right. Okay, so here he goes with Trail of Fire. The backs are phoenix-like, these are reversible. And the Magician, the Alchemist. Really interesting card. The scroll he holds here says in Latin, Igne narura renovabirur integra, which is translated as through fire all will be reborn in its entirety. And this is the alchemist's stove and three types of alchemic fire are born in it. I love this card, I love this magician, as this deck is not as of wands and pentacles, and this is whole just fire, different types of fire. We will reach that as we go, but therefore he has no other tools here but creating this different types of fire. So next is the High Priestess. She holds a blue fire. Blue fire in my country has been called as spirit fire. Whenever you see in the fireplace or in the campfire the little blue fires, then the fire spirits are present. So I love to gaze at the fire when it's either at the fireplace or wherever it is. I just love to look how it moves, and I've seen this blue fire, greenish blue and neon blue, is it, fire, quite many times. So in this deck, this blue fire is representing the higher knowledge and the wisdom within. And the book says that it is the sacred flame. The Empress, just look at this card. This is not your typical gentle pregnant Empress here. Here you can see determination and power and manifesting. And this is the New Zealand Goddess of Fire. I'm not gonna try to pronounce that. Beautiful card. The Emperor. Not your usual Emperor either. This is the energy of the individual, Kundalini, born of a spark. It's divided to represent both of the earthly part, the heart, and the spiritual part, sacrificial fire. On the ram, and again the blue, and the usual flames here. The Hierophant, really, really lovely. There's a story in the little white book that Matarisvan stole fire from Agni and delivered it to a priest. This reminds me a little bit the story of the Prometheus from ancient Greek mythology, who also gave fire to people when the gods had been taken that away as a punishment. Really beautiful. The Lovers, Japanese gods, hanging from the rainbow, created the world and the spark of fire. God's names are Izanagi and Izanami. I'm just saying as I see them, so if you know the correct pronunciation, then I'm happy for you. Otherwise, you just have to bear with me. These are like yin and yang come together to form the primary force of creation. The Chariot. Well, look at that. Absolutely different. This is the African people myth of Fulbe, initiatic journey of Kaidara. The raft he's standing on is a symbol of a voyage that the soul must take to purify itself. And he has fire and what looks like gold for me. So material things and the spiritual things, aka inner fire. You have to balance and learn to use them both in a balanced way. Justice. See that? They are pretty dark cards, but I'm guessing you can see the feather here and the heart here. This is Egyptian god of the underworld, and he is about to sentence the man's soul. Justice in this deck represents cosmic balance and harmony between reason and emotions. Even if I wouldn't read the little white book, I haven't read this far. I just looked at some of the explanations. I would say you can immediately understand what's going on in here without even being explained, because it's shown pretty well, in my opinion. At least I was so excited and amazed about so many cards in here, and we will get to them. But this is the Hermit from Australia, the old Karakaruk hid fire in her walking stick during man's solitary search for hidden secrets. It is reason that illuminates obscurity. It is reason that illuminates obscurity. You can see his fire hitting these two snakes are in the tail. Are they coming out from this fire? Or is she hitting them? Absolutely different hermit, isn't it? Every card in here is different than the usual Rider White whatever system I've seen so far. The Wheel. This is Ixion. Serve his sentence in the starry sky. The Wheel represents the life cycle. The beginning and the end are one in the eternal flow. They haven't said who is the Ixion. I'm guessing it's Roman or Greek. Roman. Haven't heard that in Greek stories. Strength. Mutsios Gevola burns his own arm, guilty of having failed. The mind completes the substance that is man, preferring reason to instinct. Am I right? He's punishing himself for failure. But you have to be strong and brave to do it. The Hanged Man. Not upside down this time. And this is Prometheus. Mediator between man and the divine. His sacrifice grants man the knowledge of fire. He represents the individual capable of overcoming pain and adversities to realize his own ideals. Absolutely love this deck. Death. See the spirit fires here? Illusions represent the aspirations and potential that every individual has within, the hope of rebirth and renewal. Amazing card. Temperance. Finland story, our neighbor. In Kalevala, the spark created by Ukko, the king of the gods, swallowed by a pike after being robbed, is recovered by Väinämöinen. Water is the primordial symbol of life. Fire represents the soul that is being guarded before being renewed. So the what's the fish in English? I don't even know. I'm sure I've never heard of it even. I'm not into fish so much. So the fish is the king of the gods here, the Ukko. In our language, the king of the gods, who also was the king of the lightning, and his name was Ukko. So we have pretty similar names on our gods here. Beautiful artwork also. The devil. See that? The devil. Moloch, the devil, is the foul creature that contaminates everything, even in innocence. He is the angel who fell for having believed in temptations and irrationalities, allowing his own mind to become clouded with earthly passions. The Tower. The eruption of Vesuvius destroys Pompeii, the fire that burns and purifies. The light first dazzles and then blinds. Amazing. No falling people, but we all know what happened in the Pompeii. Beautifully shown also. The stars from Australia. For the ancient alliance between the heavens and the earth, primigenial man through the cosmic tree became a star, which means harmony with the universe. we have in our stories also the stories that someone climbed the world tree and tried to reach for the stars to get himself one, and for that he was punished to be one of the stars himself. Beautiful card. Stars are like persons or souls there. The moon, absolutely amazing. This is so well shown with the spider web being the either the tool so you can feel the energies around you like spiders do, but it can also be a harness for you so you'll be stuck in there. And the serpent here with the fire. This is North American. The snake brings man the fire of knowledge, while the illusory power of the moon is momentarily checked. Knowledge is concealed by any illusions. The sun from China. The celestial archer is told to destroy the excess suns to prevent drought and devastation. The sun is the symbol of a strength that is both destructive and regenerative. The warrior is the person who restores order and puts an end to chaos. Amazing. Judgment. Looks like Judgment Day, the movie. Fire destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, sources of sin. Destruction gives rise to life. And the world, from Greek mythology, the birth of Phanes, the hermaphrodite, enclosed in the cosmic egg, represents equilibrium achieved. The reciprocal exchange between matter and spirituality and harmony of the elements. And he is surrounded by the astrological signs. Lion here, deer, head, and ram and snake. Beautiful. I'm amazed how much messages I've gotten just from looking through them. Once I showed them to my dear husband also, and he was like, oh, this is the coolest deck you have so far. So I'm kinda thinking that also, because this is a really good tech to explore all kinds of things, not just everyday life things. For that I can use pretty much any other deck I have, but this and the elementals and the dark grimoire, like Sekoli, they have for different reasons and for other purposes altogether. So this is the Aries, is it? And Ruby and Fire. Two of Wands making the fire, and the sun is rising. Nature is making light and fire, and the person is making light and fire. I'm not sure if I would, if I should or would right now read from the book also. I don't know. I can't ask you now, can I? Every card is associated with some country story or a deity or god from their beliefs, religions, myths, whatnot. So this is Africa. A man creates fire with the elements around him. So use the stuff you have to create. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry. Three of Wands. Woodpecker here with fire. And this story is from China. Animals contribute to the discovery of fire. The three distinctive elements complement each other: bird, man, and fire. The man is taking the spark with this branch. Four of Wands from Japan. Sacred fire is born in a procession. Harmony between man and the divine temple here, and torch bearing people going up there. Five of Wands, Vishnu and Brahma are separated by a column of fire. This is a power struggle. Two passionate characters. This is like vortex or whirlwind, which signifies movement and maybe irrational and uncontrollable powers. Six of Wands, Shiva dancing, the Natya, the dance pose she has, which is continual cosmic transformation dance, and she stands on a man here. And the card says to be meaning interior stability, calm that makes us a point of reference for those around us. For me, this says you can't fight the powers right now. They will crush you if you try, so better let things move as they will go. Seven of Wands, New Guinea. The lizard detaches a finger of fire. Astuteness and courage to succeed in working towards one's own goals. Well, the lady looks frightened, to say at least, to be, you see, this is not the happy face. Eight of Wands. From Russia, the energy of summer solstice. is channeled into the great fiery wheels that head out to help the sun. The culmination within an eternal cycle. Nine of Wands from India, walking hot coals, faith and courage to reinforce the psyche and give the life force to one's own karma. One of the men is holding the banner. One of the men is holding the little baby Ganesha. And one man has this child on his shoulders. Oh, really beautifully shown also. And the lightning behind them. Ten of Wands. Ritual of some kind. The goat and the pig here, and the gods have chosen the pig apparently from an offering from this man, not from this. The lightning bolt points to the true god on Mount Carmel, the divine sign. Challenge one's own ideals in order not to stray from the trodden path. Knave of Wands, no person here. Just the fire and the carving of the face of a man. And the Shintoist symbolism, a capable person with strong initiative. Knight of Wands, also no person here, only horse. The Grant, a demon that announces disasters. The Knight is a person who follows his own instinct, an energy that runs out before reaching your objective. The horse here, the Grant. Grant, I'm not sure how it's to be said, but the city down there looks to be on fire. Queen of Wands. The Basque goddess Mari transforms coal into gold. The Queen is an intelligent woman gifted with magnetism, capable of influencing those around her. Sheep there. Innocence. And the Fox as a King of Wands. Fire Fox. The Red Fox in the Spire of Fire. The King is a man of power who demands of others the same behavior he expects of himself. This is the best explanation of King of Wands so far I've seen, because this is my, not birth card, but the archetype card, one of them, along with strength. And this card, pretty much how it's said, demands of others the same behavior he expects of himself. I'm like that kinda in my basic raw self. I've been working on it because demanding it is not quite the thing to do. And this is the sign of Leo here. in my opinion. So the yellow stone with Ace of Chalices, and I'm not sure if they even describe the stone here. Would it be the citrine, maybe? The zodiac sign of Leo and Topaz. The lion is domesticated fire. The hearth, vigor and perfection. It represents total love. I am starting to understand my what pulled me into this, getting this deck, because I'm a Leo and the fire, of course, and the sun and everything. I'm drawn to the sea and the fire a lot, and the forest, but I don't like rivers and lakes so much. They are like standing still for me. Even the rivers, the water is not clean. I can't go swim in them. Our rivers here are pretty muddy, should I say? Is this the right word? Their water is not so clean. Lakes are pretty clean, but I still like the salty water the most. And okay, enough about me, let's talk about the cards. Chalices, and two of them. Beautiful card also. Celtic rituals, the festival of fire, Beltane, 1st of May. Two is the card of love, whether physical or spiritual, the magnetism that bonds two beings. So this deck is closely connected to the Wheel of the Year of the paganism, Celtic and Norse. Another reason to love this deck even more. Because in my country we live according to the Wheel of Year, mostly. Many people have urbanized by now, but this is how it's always been. At least in my family, and I shall give that knowledge to my children, so it will be continuing. Three of Chalices, Celtic rituals also, the festival of fire, Samhain, 31st of October. Fire dispels the spirit of the dead. This card indicates a sense of trust and happiness that grants a simple outlook on life. Four, Celtic rituals, festival of fire, Imbolc, 2nd of February, the manifestation of the purifying power of the fire, satisfaction for objectives achieved is coupled with the beginning of doubts of for the future. What was this? Second of February. In here they do this cattle thing on spring equinox. Five of Chalices, Melanesia, the affective and physical detachment between father, god of the sea, and sun, god of fire. The pain caused by giving up the life lived up to this point. I see different things on these cards than they are explained there. I see departure or lust for something they can't touch or reach. This is Six of Chalices, Australia. The native Gondole steals fire from the whale. Seize the day and abandon yourself to the joys of the present. Who was that who in the stories were swallowed by the whale and lived in his belly for quite a time? I can't remember who was that. Somewhere I know I've read it. Seven of Chalices, and this is again Celtic rituals, Festival of the Sun, Yule or Alban Arturi Artuan. 31st of December. The druid burns the Yule log in honor of the newborn sun. Fantasy overcomes the barriers of the mind to make dreams come true. Eight of Chalices. Celtic rites. Festival in honor of Brigid, the goddess of fire, the moon in all its forms and illusions. The goddess sees the dark side of man and shows him the futility of fretting. Well, you can read how do you see the cards. I'm not agreeing with the little white book all the time, but I want to give you the chance to know the deck maybe a little bit more or better. Oh, the sun is coming this way. I must make it quicker because it will be so overexposed you can't see anything. Nine of Chalices. Queensland Islands, man stole fire from the dying sun. Look how it's taking the fire. Ten of Chalices, Mexico. Tlalpanek, marriage is sealed with fire. Knave of Chalices. Seal of Solomon, the vertices of which indicate fire and water. Knight, Sigurd, leaps over the wall of fire. This is Norse story. Queen of Chalices, a woman draws the sign corresponding to the Ken, rune, torch healing. Is this pronounced as Ken, this rune here? I'm not sure. Isn't it the... Let me check. Okay, Ken, yes, it's the other version of saying that. Kenos is the one that I knew of. Or Kaun. So, King of Chalices is the dragon. Chinese dragon lives in water and is kind to men. The king is a cultured person seeking to instill others with his knowledge. Yeah, you can pretty much use this deck as intuitive, because I see a lot of lot more here than the little white book says. But it's interesting to know the all the stories of the world and the names of the fire gods. And okay, this is Ace of Swords, Sagittarius and Sapphire. Two of Swords from India. The funeral pyre allows the spirit of the deceased to be purified and conducted towards a mystical ascension. This is the way they sent away people in my country in earlier days, much earlier. However, a year ago or so, we had one witch here who was very powerful and wrote many books and helped so many people. He applied for the state to allow to have a burning to be burnt at his own yard after he died, and they granted him the wish. Actually, his relatives and people around him fulfilled his wish before anyone could stop them. It was a really big discussion here, but you can't really, you don't hear that people doing that around here, because, well, laws and reasons. So Two of Swords, it's really beautifully shown as the soul here takes the hand of this higher being. Here's the Three of Swords, knife, and the Flower of Fire here. Looks like she's in the jail, but the light is still coming from the outside. This is Aztec myth. The sun transforms itself, its own bride, whose death he is responsible for, into a tulip. Tragic love is transformed and regenerated. Four of Swords, Aztec myth, Quetzalcoatl. I'm gonna show you this. You probably know what I'm talking about. But oh my God, all this Quetzalcoatl. So sets himself on fire for having raped his sister and transforms himself into the planet Venus. So this is not a crack character from the fairy tale after all, and gives this whole thing absolutely another twist. Five of Swords, Australian myth, the black swan saves fire but does not sense the witch's presence. Disappointment and bitterness due to the defeat. Well, I can see that when you get this card, whoever, whatever you're trying to do, there's someone who's trying to weigh you down. Six of Swords. See the flame changing color as he ascends. Hebrew myth. The purifying flame goes from red to white. This is the search for the truth for those who have made it the center of their own life. Beautifully shown card. Seven of Swords. Mongolia. A shaman expresses his own energy with fire. I can see quarrel or have to be minding who you burn or what do you say. But the card says difficulty and obstacles along your path. Well, these are difficulty and obstacles that your tongue can actually create. Eight of Swords. The Pentacles. Spiritual help is necessary to overcome adversities and strengthen the soul. Meditation ring, and every one of them has this blue fire of spirit. Nine of Swords. The myth of Eros and Psyche. Eros is the flame of desire that Psyche cannot resist. In the end, she loses her lover and herself. I can see getting burned here. When you go for things that you think are good or maybe even risky. Ten of Swords. This is Aztec myth, a human sacrifice to light the new fire. A negative view of life that leads to losing all confidence in oneself and in others. See, he has her heart in his hand, and someone will hurt you and take your heart. At first glance, I thought these were his legs, and I was like, why is this leg so weird? And then I realized it's a woman here on the altar. Definitely evil. Someone's gonna do evil things. Knave of Swords. This is Aztec myth. The old god bears fire in a brazier on his head. A reserved and conservative person who follows the routine of life. Knight of Swords. The sixth angel of the apocalypse plays his horn. The knight indicates waiting for a trial, the strength of the soul, courage. Lion's head on the horse, spitting fire, fire or sword. For me, it's telling another story. He's defending himself, not waiting for a trial, but actually maybe fighting for whoever is trying to judge you. The Queen of Swords. Not a pretty card. I can see why this deck is not popular. But these were the things that actually were done ages ago. They sacrificed people, so did the Norse people, they did it here, they did it in Egypt, they have done it everywhere. So if you can't accept the facts of history and even not try to understand why they did it, they didn't have enough knowledge or understanding of things, and so they try to live their life as we try now, maybe from 500 years the generations will look back to our life and think that we were actually pretty stupid and did awful things. So open mind is a good thing to have. You can't just deny things that you don't like. So this is the Basque goddess. No, I'm sorry, I'm reading from the wrong place. To grant him immortality, Isis immerses the son of the queen of Byblos into the sacred fire. And see that. What does the little white book say to the character of this? This is an intelligent woman who challenges social conventions to face the difficulties in life. So think about that. And here's the Phoenix from the back of the card. This is the King of Swords. Phoenix is born and is regenerated by the fire. The king, thanks to his spirit of self-sacrifice, grants life and substance to dreams. He is the symbol of rebirth and tangibility. The light is going extra here, but we will see the last suit also. This is Ace of Pentacles, the salamanders here, the trinity of the three preceding elements from the Aces, Sagittarius. I can't know. Well, you can see Leo and you know. And this is Pentacles. Let me see. All the zodiac signs linked to fire and the salamander that represents it. No, then this is Aries, not... okay. Fire signs. The alchemist's fire gives rise to matter and creates life. Two of Pentacles, New Guinea. Fire hides in many places, even under the skirt of an old woman. The spirit of initiative and lively intelligence. Well, you see, this is not your usual deck to work with, and still can tell quite a lot. Three of Pentacles. God makes us use of fire to convey his laws. The number three represents the thought that manifests itself in the material world. Concealed within each man is divine breath. I take that card as getting information from higher planes. Four of Pentacles, Germany, the birth of Ymir, the primordial giant. The line between God and good and evil is sometimes very thin. I love that. And the fire and ice emerges, not the friendly So, Five of Pentacles. This is South America. A fire destroyed the land of the Toba Indians, but they were reborn. Fire destroys but creates new life under the ashes. Six of Pentacles, Nike, winged victory, and the Olympic flame. Altruism, generosity, and know-how to put everything at stake for one's own ideals. Seven of Pentacles, Nero's madness. Material success and power bring with them the seed of destruction for those who are not stable enough. Beautifully shown. And despite the city being on fire, he's just with a victory breath on his head playing the harp. So you are either mad to be this calm in the chaos, or you, if you can't do anything about it, then stay calm. Eight of Pentacles. This is Hephaestus creates thunderbolts for Zeus. Through work, we can bridle energy and channel it stably. They beautifully said, you are doing the God's work, or work for gods. Nine of Pentacles, Normandy. God donates fire to the Wren. The richness of the spirit radiates around us. Ten of Pentacles, an Assyrian man and wife honor the god of the hearth, Gebil. Peace at home is the symbol of harmony and spiritual enrichment. I'm making, is this onion or garlic sacrifices here? Here's something pictured to someone with a shield, I can, and a dog. And no lion, really, really bad to even see without the camera. Okay. This is the Knave of Pentacles. Whales, a symbolic vision of the Mabinogion. Decision and perseverance are the attributes of the Knave, capable of facing even perils. Kind of strong person, as I can tell, and fire is on the half of that, so he has balance in it. You can't keep the tree if you can't manage the fire. Okay, Knight of Pentacles. The Bible, the Book of Kings. The lifting of the prophet Elijah into the heavens. The knights represent energy in perpetual motion. This is a concrete and capable person. So the knights and the court cards are definitely thought as persons here. This is not how I usually read them, but well, only one Bible reference, which is nice, but for the variety and truthfulness of the stories we have around the world, this is great that they added it here. So you can't deny the existence of the Bible and it being as much of a story as any culture else had. This is just a thing that's been most popular. And as they say, the winners write the history. So, okay, the Queen of Pentacles. Dakota Tribe, North America. The peace pipe brought by the white buffalo dressed as the goddess Hope. I'm gonna show you. This is WH. So that. I'm gonna spell it for you. WHOPE. White buffalo is behind her, and here is a person. So the queen means is a woman capable of positively transforming elements she comes into contact with. And the king of pentacles, the chimera. The king represents the material world and chimera. Yes, the king represents the material world and the continual search for stimuli to reach higher and higher levels. Chimera. I'm not sure how it's pronounced in English, but yes, this was the deck. The little white book explains a little bit in the end here, the five flames. I'm gonna put that here. The five flames chalices indicates the fire that warms relationships with other people or the state of loves and friendship. Pentacles indicates the fire of the heart or one's own physical condition and health. Wands indicates the fire of creativity or the state of ambitions and desires. And swords indicates the fire of the mind, of the intellectual, communicative and cultural state. Major Arcana indicates the divine and spiritual fire or the general condition of the person. Sorry, I should have shown you the cards meanwhile I read it, but I have only two hands and the little white books can't just stay open. So yes, this is the Tarot of Fire. I love that deck a lot. It joins the whole world and its stories in one tool, I can say, and I find it absolutely awesome. I respect every belief system there is, because everything, every culture have right to their deities and stories. You can't just go around and push your stories to everyone else though. That's why the religion and whole thing has this negative taste to it. But if you can look over it, we have so many different cultures around the world. We just can't go and mix them, force mix them all together and expect great results from there. So everything that's forced is going to be hated and will be crashing sooner or later. So my conclusion, this is one of the awesomest deck I have. I will be using this one a lot. I'm gonna contemplate over the cards and the house I see them though. And I'm not sure about this orange, why they do that? Because the images are, the artwork and images are so beautiful. Why they even go and put those ugly borders around them? And I'm not sure, I'm really, really tempted to trim this deck, but I'm not sure if I should do that. Because it will not mess up the backs, but the cards, I'm not sure. I'm gonna Google if anyone's done it and decide if I like them or not. I don't mind them being smaller, but I don't want to lose the back images and the overall appearance of the deck. And I can't edge them either, because here it's orange and here it's red. So if I try to make it red, then I will smear it. I'm sure I will. And black I just can't do well. I will have to see about that. But yes, this was the Tarot of Fire. And thanks for watching. And I will put the link to the Amazon where you can see how much the deck is. And if you want, you can get yourself one as well. I'm gonna put the Amazon UK there, because this is the main Amazon I'm using. And well, you can see if it's available. In my opinion, it is. And this was the Deck of Fire. Thank you for watching. Bye.